This is Support is Sexy, episode 393, and today we're going to talk about how to know when experience meets inspiration. Welcome to Support is Sexy. I'm your host, Elayne Fluker, entrepreneur, author, and founder of Chic Rebellion Media. 5 days a week, Monday through Friday, I bring you inspiring women entrepreneurs who share their wins and lessons to help you take your business to the next level. Here we go. Hi, everyone. Welcome to a new episode of Support is Sexy. I'm so happy to have you here because it just would not be the same without you. And today, you know, last week on episode 389, last Friday, episode 389, I spoke about the perfect combination of when experience meets inspiration. And I shared with you the evolution of girlonpodcast.com, which is a new booking service that I launched just for women entrepreneurs, leaders, and creatives who want to appear as guests on podcasts. It's an excellent marketing strategy, and pairing women who podcast with women who guest is something that I'm already passionate about. So I created this business around it, girlonpodcast.com. But in episode 389, I spoke about how that experience, which was over the holiday period, really, that inspiration came to me, and it combined all of my experience working in media, then doing podcasting and being passionate about connecting women and creating spaces for women to share their stories, how all of that came together. What I realized later, though, was that I didn't really tell you how you might be able to do that as well. Now, I know I always say, let go of the how, don't worry about the how, but I can at least share with you my experience of how that worked and how you might be able to do it too. So that's different than worrying about the how. This way, it's just, this is my experience. This is how you might be able to do it as well. Does that make sense? So that's what I'm going to share with you today, how experience can meet inspiration in your business, in your life. So the first step, I believe, is look around. What are you already doing? What are you great at? What comes easily? What makes time fly? These are all things that you've heard before, but think about it. When is the last time you paused from whatever you're currently doing, whatever you're currently face down into? When was the last time you paused and looked around and said, but what am I really great at doing? What comes easily to me and what makes the time fly? As much as I know, I say little puns here and there about podcasting and editing and all those things that take a lot of my time. And I don't beef about it or complain about it, but it is a lot and it's time consuming. But I love it and it makes time fly. That's why it's time consuming, or that's why I don't notice, I should say, just how time consuming it is, because I could do it for hours. I absolutely love it. I had no idea I was going to love it like this, especially the result of it. Not even so much, I should say, the bits and pieces of putting the whole thing together, but getting to connect with women entrepreneurs literally all around the world. That's not just a phrase I use. Speaking to women all around the world, being able to, more importantly, share their stories and the things that they confided in me during our conversation and know that I'm going to share with you. It's overwhelming how much I appreciate it and appreciate you for being here. But I had no idea what that experience was going to be like, how much time it was going to take. I looked at what I was good at the time, not necessarily talking, but sharing stories. I did the work, podcasting in this case, and it makes the time fly. I don't even realize it. And then that evolved into Girl on Podcast. Taking again a moment of reflection, or living the question. You know, we're all about that, right? Being open. Living the question, what should I do next? What could I be doing? What can I do to grow my business? What can I do to be of more service? Those were some of the questions that I was asking myself when experience met inspiration and turned into girlonpodcast.com. So for you, again, think about it. Questions you already know, or questions you know you've heard people say, these are the things you should ask yourself when you're thinking about pivoting or starting something new or reinventing. What are you great at? What comes easily, and what makes time fly? Then the other thing, get inspiration from people and brands that you admire. I just had a great conversation about this. This isn't about comparing yourself to someone else, oh, they have this, so I need to get that. But you don't need to reinvent the wheel. look around and see what are the great websites that you think are beautiful. Who are the, if you want to be a speaker, who are the speakers that you admire? If you want to be a writer, who are the writers that you love? Are you reading their work? Are you finding out where they went to school? Are you finding out what their practice is? Are you finding out what their morning routine is? I have entrepreneurs and women speakers and writers and all kinds of different people that I admire. I want to know, what do they do to be successful? As Tony Robbins says, success leaves clues. So model the success of the people that you look up to or admire, or even if it's your peers. These aren't people who are necessarily 1,000 steps away from you. These might be people who are your peers who are doing some great things that you have within your mind, within your vision, or a part of your vision. It might not even be all of what they're doing, but you have a sense that you want to be able to do that. You know, that's one of the reasons that I really love podcasts, because people aren't afraid to share their how on podcasts. When you get someone on a podcast, whether it's on my own show or if I listen to other shows, most people are sharing their exact process or the things that they feel make them successful or the things that they feel make their businesses successful. There are other spaces where people don't necessarily do that, or they don't want to share everything, or they don't want to give everything away. I find, or at least the podcast that I listen to, and certainly the women who have been on my show, are very generous. So even if you're, whether you're listening to a podcast or you're having a one-on-one conversation with someone, get a sense from them as much as you can. What do they feel makes them successful in a particular thing? Don't leave it too open-ended, but if there's something specific that you want to know about, you could say, if there was one thing that you could tell me as a piece of advice, what would it be? Or if there was one thing that you wish you knew when you first started out, that's a question I like to ask. What would you tell yourself, or what would you tell someone who's thinking about going into whatever that space is? So think about those kinds of questions. And if you're not able to ask the person, if it's someone who is out of reach, do your research. Be inspired. Again, look around. What are other people in your space that you're looking up to? Not just scrolling on the gram and see what everybody's doing and getting upset and even jealous of what everyone else is. That's not what we're talking about. Strategic inspiration, if that's even a term. Strategic inspiration. You want to be focused on the things that will really help you move forward and be inspired by those things. Again, success leaves clues, so model that success. And as I mentioned, you can get inspiration anywhere. So maybe you're going to a speech to hear your favorite speaker or author or anything like that. Or maybe you're just reading their book, or you're signed up to their email, or you're reading their blog, or you're listening to their podcast. I'm not saying you admire me, but I appreciate you being here. You are listening. Whatever you can do, there's so many ways now to get, quote unquote, in touch with people, or to find out information about what people are up to, public people, what they're up to, what they're doing, and to see how they did it, how they built it. A great thing that I'm starting to do, which a lot of entrepreneurs have talked about, is reading autobiographies and biographies of great entrepreneurs. You want to hear about their lives. You want to hear about their struggles. You want to hear about their challenges. You want to hear about obstacles that they overcome, and you want to hear about their greatness. What helped them make it through? How did they become great at their thing? Even if it's not exactly in your field, you can still be inspired by reading about, learning about, listening to, getting in spaces where you're around other entrepreneurs, where you can learn from other entrepreneurs. So don't limit yourself to, say, if you're in college right now, some of my listeners are in school, which I appreciate. Hey, keep going. You can do it. So if you're in school, even don't think that your education just has to come from your schoolwork or your classroom or things like that. You can be into some other things. You party, you do this, you do that. You're on social media. Great. But you can be into some other things that really edify you and that will help give you inspiration for where you want to go. If there's a field that you're interested in, no matter what anybody else thinks, if it's entrepreneurship or anything else, get inspiration in those areas. Do some research, follow some folks who are really doing things the way that you'd like to do, or that you can see yourself, you see a reflection of yourself, or it gives you inspiration that you say, I'm not sure I'm going to do it like that, but here's what I can do. You can make it into your own, right? Take the inspiration, make it into your own. And then to piggyback on making it into your own, take inspired action. When you're at the point where you do feel like that inspiration and your experience has come together, like I talked about with girlonpodcast.com, I literally felt pulled to create this thing. Where will it go? I don't know. But I'm excited to be on this journey, and I felt it, that I was pulled to do this. So when you feel that pull, even if it's just a little tug, make sure you take inspired action. Inspired action doesn't have to be jumping out the window. You don't have to take the full leap. Maybe you've got a full-time job, you're thinking about it, but you really feel pulled to do this entrepreneurial thing. Well, can you take the first step of writing things down, writing the idea down, the inspiration when it comes? You must capture it. You know I'm big on journaling, so write it down. That is an inspired action. Then think, what is the first step I can take? Don't get caught up. This is when you don't want to get caught up in how am I going to go from here to my vision. You don't know exactly how that's going to work. You might not have all the steps mapped out. Honestly, none of us really does. We're all figuring it out as we go along. So what I want you to do is focus on that first domino. We've talked about that. Wow, I don't know how long ago that was. That was a while ago. We did an episode on that, right? Focusing on that first domino. Think about dominoes. When they're standing up, you tilt that first one, and then the rest of them fall down one over the other once they get that momentum going. So focus on your first domino. What is your first step that you know to take, right or wrong? Doesn't matter. Your best, what you don't know, which you don't know, right? Your best step at this time. What's the next best move? What is the next best move that you can make toward that inspiration, towards that inspired action, so that you can move forward? That next move, and then the following step will reveal itself. And then after you do that, even if what you've done is not perfect. So for me, with setting up girlonpodcast.com, I set up that first landing page for women who host, so podcast hosts to go to and click on and join the list. And then for women who guest, to click on the button in order to schedule a consultation with me so we can talk more about the services. Created that landing page. Is it perfect? No. It's cute though. I will say it's cute. girlonpodcast.com. But is it perfect? No. Is it a full website? No. But I took that inspired action. That was my first domino. Get this up, set this up, and the next page, it has the prices and all those things on it. Get those things up so you can get started. And then you will continue to evolve from there. So don't wait until it's perfect. Don't wait until that perfect, or till that first domino, I should say, looks perfect or everything seems. First of all, it's never going to be perfect. Even if you think so, someone else can find something wrong with it. Feel good about it, but know that you're going to continue to evolve. And then let people know what you're up to. So that was the thing for me. As I mentioned in episode 389, I thought about who are women who could use my services with whom I'm already in touch. And I thought about the women who had appeared already on the Support is Sexy podcast. That was over 200 women. So I emailed them, hey, this is what I'm up to. Let me know if you're interested, or if you know anyone who is, please be sure to forward it to them. And the response has been fantastic. Now, again, I mentioned in the last episode, I wouldn't do that to them all the time. I don't want to pitch them over and over again because they were kind enough to give their time and be guests. They're not people who signed up for an email list, for example. But still, I couldn't be afraid to let them know what I'm up to, especially if this is my they are literally my target audience. Women who are on podcasts, whether they do it all the time or they were on my show and I was the only show they were on. And I have women who are in both of those categories, but luckily they had a great experience when they were on Support is Sexy. So they were open to doing more podcasts, whether it's now or later. But if they didn't even know that I was doing that, then they just wouldn't know, and I just wouldn't have an opportunity to talk to them and tell them about what I'm up to and to get feedback. That's the other part. Get feedback. You want feedback on your website or whatever you're creating. Feedback is information. In fact, feedback can also be inspiration. You never know. Someone might tell you something or tell you a service that they wish you had, and you think, oh, maybe I'll add that to the list. I had another conversation with a woman today that a mutual business coach friend connected me to, and she and I are going to exchange what kind of things we'd want in our own businesses, because we offer sort of complementary services, but not the same services, but we can get feedback from each other to make our services better. But again, if I wasn't out there with Girl on Podcast, I wouldn't even be having that conversation. So get your first domino up. Tilt it over. Doesn't have to be perfect. The other ones will fall, and you will continue to evolve over time, and make sure that you tell people what you're up to. It doesn't have to be perfect before you share it. It doesn't have to be perfect before you let people know what you're up to. You are going to get feedback along the way and continue to evolve. All right. So hopefully this was helpful. I gave you a little bit of how, a little bit of experience, a little bit of inspiration. All of that goes into the mix when you're creating something sexy in your life, in your business. These are the things to think about. And a lot of it, I'm sure you'll say, well, I know all that. I've heard that before. Great. Are you putting that in action? Are you taking action on those things? Are you trying to get to a space where your inspiration meets your experience and it feels like such a powerful moment that you're moving forward confident that this is the thing? And not to say that your business has to be the thing. For me, that's how I move. That's how I can work on things all night. That's how I stay encouraged. That's how I stay confident in what I'm doing. That's how I have to feel like I'm making a difference. Those things, I need those things to be aligned with who I am, my vision, but also my experience and inspiration. I need those things to come together. So if you're that type of person, these are some of the questions to ask yourself. These are some of the things that you can do or try. Let me know how it goes, that you can do or try in order to have your inspiration and your experience come together for the perfect combination. All right, so thank you so much for being here. If you want to find out more about Girl on Podcast, go to girlonpodcast.com. I'd love to hear from you. I can give you any inspiration. I meant to say information, but inspiration is the thing we're talking about. I can give you any information or inspiration that you need. I'm happy to connect with you. girlonpodcast.com. All right, so until next time, always remember, you deserve support. And I'll talk to you soon. Take care.